When they were children, he did not used to just admonish them without purpose. Look at the ones when he was praying and his grandson was on his back. It delayed him from getting up from sujood and prostration to the degree that some people thought, what has happened? And then they noticed this is the grandson of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam on his back in salah. Imagine playing games. I want to ask you a question. We are not inviting the imams of the masajid to do the same. But if the imam of your masjid was in salah, was in sujood a little bit long because his child was on his back, what would you do? That's a question. What would you do? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us, really. It reminds me of a story in India where there was an imam who something of this nature happened to him and they really harassed him. Apparently this is supposed to be a true story. You know, some people want to know, is it true, is it not true? It's not just an example, it's a true story. They say this imam, he was so upset that he told them, you know what, you people are hassling me so much, harassing me, one day I'll leave you in sujood and I'll disappear. And so they thought it was a joke. This foolish imam actually did it. He went in sajda and he prolonged the first one. So when he prolonged the first one and he came up from it, after a long time, people thought, okay, this man has got a long sajda today. He went in for the next one. When he noticed everyone is down, he went out of the trap door in the front of the mihrab and he was gone. So be careful. If we treat our imams in such a way, and I know we are speaking to many nationalities here this evening, but wherever you are from, and no matter who you mix with, the imam, you need to treat him thoroughly and properly. He lights a lot of candles, you need to know this. And it's not easy. Don't blow his, because by blowing his candle, remember one thing, it will affect a lot of other candles at the same time. You have a problem, an issue, talk to him in private with respect. Because you need to know there are people who look up to him with respect as well. So this is why I was saying, no matter what our nationality is, when we go back home or wherever we are, the imam of the masjid, he really needs that extra point of respect from us. Without it, we may be guilty of not doing enough to help others light the candles of others. And this brings me to another level. Islam is so beautiful that sometimes my candle, I might not be able to light so many with it because of perhaps where I am sitting and what's happening and so on. By me supporting others who are lighting the candles of tons of people, I am getting a full reward of all of that. That is Islam. And this is why we are taught, أَدَّالُ عَلَى الْخَيْرِ كَفَاعِلِهِ. A person who points towards goodness, a person who instructs towards goodness, a person who encourages others to do good, is similar in reward to those who have done it or to the doer.